female reproductive health is so important and people don't realize how important it is. And once those eggs are destroyed in the ovary, that's it, they're gone. And if they're bad quality, the offspring are going to suffer. So I think it's a huge overlooked area of research. And it doesn't just apply to the human side of things. It's the same is true for animals. So we study how chemicals in the environment can impact fertility in women and female animals. We also study what factors are important for producing a good quality egg to be ovulated. We're really the only group who's looking at the impact, kind of the additive effect of obesity on chemical exposure in the ovary. It's kind of a niche area that we've developed.
This is kind of tedious, but it involves going through every one of the sections.
I'm from Galway, which is on the west coast of Ireland. So I grew up out in the countryside, even though we weren't farmers ourselves, but we were surrounded by farms. So I liked being outside, I liked animals, I liked science. So I originally wanted to be a veterinarian, and there was an old man who lived next to us who used to own a lot of the land around where we lived. He kind of brought us around and like showed us, you know, where to pick mushrooms, where to get hazelnuts, where to, like, he always had some animals. And I think he turned us into country kids, because there's a lot of engineers in my family, but I knew that I really liked research. I love seeing what the experiment tells you. I love waiting for the result. It's like being a detective. You find all the pieces and then eventually you put them together and hopefully you get the right answer. I've always loved actually to read crime novels and detective novels and stuff, so maybe that's part of it, I don't know. All the different cell types that are lighting up with the green, that's where the protein MEH is being expressed in. In terms of animal production, you can make animal production more efficient. If you can have, let's say in the swine industry, if you can have sows that have better reproductive capacity and be reproductive for longer over their lifetime, that is economically better, but it's also better for animals. And if we can figure out how different stressors can affect that fertility, well then we can maybe make treatments, or not just pharmaceutical treatments, but like environmental, manipulate the environment to benefit them in the long term. So I think all of those, in terms of production agriculture, can make it more economically efficient as well as better for the animal.